Fox 16 Sports with Troy Lynch.
They're here. Hey, gang. I solved the biggest mystery of my career, what the top 10 plays of the Arkansas football season are coming into the bye week. No tricks, but 10 treats just for you. Let's get right into them. Number 10. We go back to week 7, Hogs hosting Auburn. KJ Jefferson is scarier than Michael Myers when he's got time in the pocket. Right down the middle to the scariest wide receiver in all of the SEC, Treylon Burks, of course, the ridiculous catch for the touchdown. That was the second of the day for him, too. Arkansas did lose this game, though, 38-23. Number 9, Jefferson put on a show in his home state. Ole Miss didn't have any answers for Super Jefferson. It's a bird. It's a plane. Nah, it's a touchdown. Ties the game at 31, but I couldn't just show you one of Jefferson's rushing touchdowns. The Rebels looking like they're trying to catch a ghost. Jefferson just phases through the defense to tie the game again, but you know the rest. They lost by failing a two-point conversion by one. Hey, we're going to go back to the Auburn game for number 8, and KJ's going back to Burks. Fake the jump pass. Touchdown. I haven't been this fooled since I got toothpaste while trick-or-treating back in 2006. And yeah, I remember that date. It scarred me. 3 plays, and we've already seen 2 touchdowns from Burks. And it's not going to be the last time we see of him. He's haunting these top plays. Number 7. Let's take you back to the Texas Shining game. Here's Rocket. Rocket Sanders locks the Longhorns up in room 217 with his 27-yard run. And on this day, Red Rum spelled backwards was touchdown. The freshman shined and the Hogs won 40-21, blowing out and upsetting Texas. Hey, number 6, though. Hogs at Jerry's World against Texas A&M. It's no secret that Treylon Burks has bigger claws than Freddy Krueger, and it pays off on this play. It was Friday the 16th for the Aggies as Burks went for 167 yards, a touchdown, and this crazy catch. What a performance and what a game. Now to the top 5. If you want any advice on how to run away from a zombie horde, ghost face, or, you know, maybe a goblin, you got to take notes from Nathan Perotti. Perotti returns this punt 80 yards for a touchdown against Arkansas Pine Bluff. This was the Razorbacks' first punt return for a score since 2012. It's been a long time, but Hogs, they won this game 45-3 against the Golden Lions right here at War Memorial Stadium. Number 4 comes from week 1 against Rice, and there was some paranormal activity going on because how else do you explain how Tyson Morris made this one-handed catch? I don't even know. He even got pass interference. Is that a word? We're going to make sure it is. But he still makes the grab. Hogs definitely ate some rice this day. 38-17 win over the Owls. Number 3, though, we all go a little mad sometimes. Some people, they go psycho. Like Treylon Burks on this drive. Go up and get it. 37-yard pickup from Burks. Crazy catch. But this is a two-parter. Yeah. That's what Ole Miss was hearing on this play. But the very next play, it's the same exact one with the same exact result, but an even crazier catch. Another 37-yard pickup. That eventually leads to a goal line touchdown. But do you want to know what the most frightening thing in the world is? It's not fear. It was Arkansas's defense against Texas A&M. Look at Buster Brown going full extension for the interception. Yeah, I rhymed. It's number 2. What? I can do that. Canceling the Aggies' fourth quarter drive and keeping the Hogs' 7-point lead alive. Alive, I tell ya. But the very best play of the season so far requires you to be afraid. Be very afraid of the freshman A.J. Green. I see broken tackles. 48-yard touchdown for the Hogs. Green turned Jerry's World into a quiet place, putting the Hogs up 17-0 in the first half, eventually winning the game 20-10. And those are the top 10 Arkansas football plays of the year so far. I'm really excited to see what the rest of the season holds. Of course, they got Mississippi State coming up next week because this bye week, it was hard. I didn't know what to do on Saturday, but hope you're having a great Halloween. We got more news coming up right after this.